Hello, my name is Curt Davis, Marketing Director with Kuhn Krauss. And today we're focusing on profit till, and today our focus is going to be residue management. Right now in the fall time of the year, obviously harvest has been in full swing, and we're really focused on that number one thing for residue management is the combine, and making sure that our combine is set appropriately to start the initial phase of that residue management and getting some good pieces of residue out of the back to where we can manage that residue properly, not just right after the harvest season, but even into the springtime of the year when we're really going to be focused on creating a good seed bed and a very even distribution of residue. And that's the number one thing that we're after with the harvest operation, is making sure that we can get a good even distribution of residue for the field that won't cause us any hot spots of residue as we start into the tillage operation that will continue and further that residue management. There are a lot of different reasons why we want to get a good even distribution of residue. Number one, it really gives us a very balanced aspect to the residue pot levels in the field, which won't detrimentally affect the plant population or the emergence of that next year's crop. And also, you know, we really want to be able to manage the residue and moisture levels, which directly affects the temperature in next spring of for next year's crop in planting. So as we really come down and look at what we have here in the field today, we've got a lot of standing stalks that we really want to manage appropriately along with the other residue levels that are on the ground. We can do that a couple of different ways. If we think about vertical tillage or even a disc harrow that are going to cut residue, mix that residue with a little bit of soil. In the case of an accelerator for the vertical tillage, we're really going to use the star wheel technology to incorporate that residue into the surface of the soil and anchor that residue so it doesn't blow away with wind. The disc harrow obviously gives us a very good residue management tool in mixing that residue in the surface. And then we think about a product like a dominator for a combination primary tillage machine or even a land saver. Those products really do an excellent job of cutting residue, mixing that soil and residue at a deeper depth down to 8 inches, which really promotes residue breakdown into organic matter, which is a very critical process from now until next spring to provide that next year's crop the best chance that it has on establishing itself and having a good nutrient level to pull from in the soil. We really have a lot of residue that's matted onto the surface, even with a lot of standing stalks. Now these long pieces of residue that we have is something that we really want to cut and manage. We want those broken into smaller pieces that are definitely going to be able to be manageable by a seed bed operation in the spring and definitely a planter in the spring. So having long pieces of residue is something that we really want to address. We can do that with a product like the accelerator for vertical tillage, disc harrows, or even those primary tillage products that we talked about with the dominator and land saver. So getting those long pieces of residue broken down into smaller pieces, extremely critical. Also, the standing stalks that we have, we want to make sure that we can get those standing stalks laid down onto the surface of the ground and even mixed into that soil surface. That's going to promote the residue breakdown with the fungus, bacteria, earthworms, and other biological activity that we have in the soil profile to really convert that residue into organic matter and to where it won't become an issue for next spring's planting of next year's crop. But also, one of the things about all this residue being matted on the surface of the ground, at this point in time, it doesn't really cause us a problem in the fall time of the year. But in spring, this could really be detrimental to our emergence of next year's crop, particularly for corn or soybeans. For corn especially, we want to have a very even temperature in our field, and this residue matted on the surface of the ground will cause cold spots in the soil. And that can detrimentally affect our emergence, rate of population emergence that we're looking for, especially from a crop like corn. So with our primary tillage operation, or even with the vertical till or the disc harrows, we're able to get this mixed in, get a very even temperature for the spring. We promote that biological breakdown of the residue, and we start to provide some nutrients in the form of some residual phosphorus and potassium for next year's crop. Please visit our website at coonnorthamerica.com to learn more about our tillage products that can help you with your residue management.